underestimate your abilities. Speak up, share your ideas, be an advocate for yourself.
Some of the wonderful things that you shared here is definitely going to be an inspiration for a lot of people. Can you just tell me a bit about your role?
Multiple years, I have played the role of a technology lead in oncology and specialty domain primarily. And I am very passionate about the Women at ZS group that exists at ZS. And I'm an active member of that. And I've led the Pune chapter and the India region chapter as well.
Impressive, 16 years. So considering how you've been with the company for so long, how does ZS stand out as an employer in the tech industry?
It stands out in the tech industry primarily due to the innovative use of the cutting-edge technologies, the platforms that we have, and the strong emphasis on the data-driven analytics, right? Recently also, when I say cutting-edge technologies, so recently we had Gen AI Week at ZS, which was attended in our offshore or India offices, which was attended almost like 4,000 plus employees participated in the workshop, the learning sessions, the leadership sessions. So that in itself shows the commitment of the firm to using leading edge solutions or cutting edge solutions and technology in our problem solving, right? And also in terms of the flexibility that it offers. I didn't share anything about my personal life, but in my personal life, I have I'm born and brought up in Pune. My office is also in Pune. So it was a little easier for me to be there at home and while also work or expand on my professional career opportunities. I have two kids, and one is 7-year-old and the other one is 2-year-old. So the kind of flexibility that ZS offered during my major events in my personal life, right? The inclusive work environment, and even the overall professional development. When I came back from my first maternity break, how was it in returning to work? When I came back from my second break, what was it like? So all of these things definitely make ZS a place where women want to work and thrive, right?
So let's talk about the skills that are required. Now, skills like empathy, adaptability, and you know, problem solving are crucial skills in today's, you know, fast-paced tech environment. So can you provide some examples of how these skills have been, you know, prioritized by ZS?
That's a great question, Vandana. Empathy, adaptability, problem solving, these are indeed like essential skills in the fast-paced technology environment that we work in. At ZS, we put in a lot of emphasis and prioritize these skills and have a lot of initiatives and best practices that we typically follow. Be it men, women, everybody is empowered to speak and share their perspectives, take risks, and also contribute their overall insights. So that, I think, shows the empathy in action. Apart from that, there are multiple groups that exist. So if there are certain say issues from a belonging standpoint or anything that people want to learn from different journeys. So there are these networking and different communities that exist. So it was initially called Women's Leadership Initiative. Now it is called Women at ZS. And the focus of this group was to create more inclusive environment and provide like leadership opportunities for women, be it in tech, data science, and create that community or a platform wherein people can learn from each other's experience, share their concern, and also receive mentorship wherever required. Be it a consultant level, we have like a lot of mentorship program wherein a junior consultant is shadowing a senior person just to learn from their experience. Then even for the senior women managers, we have something called as a targeted learning program or leadership development program called Path to Principal. We also have a lot of hackathons and innovation challenge just to keep up with the pace of bringing the newness and innovative ideas to the table, and the cross-team collaboration between a number of teams that exist.
Okay, that sounds great. It brings out a well-rounded, I would say, a development, not just in personality, but in the company and those kind of things, right? So so talking about, say, women in certain roles, I mean, we've always had discussions on how can will a woman be able to fit into a certain role? So what unique perspectives do, you know, women bring to your role that help address complex business problems, also keeping the human-centric approach intact?
Imagine any AI solution which does not have any women perspective baked in, right? So the adoption of that would not be that high. So the ability to bring in that well-rounded design or creativity and thinking, which is outside the box, I think brings diverse perspective and making that product more robust and bring in like a diverse perspective, which will be more usable by end users. So that I feel is one of the very powerful plus points that women bring to the table.
So of course, we also know that it's not that easy as well. You know, there are different challenges that one has to face. So can you tell me, like, as a woman entering this field, what challenges did you face on the personal front, on the, you know, on the company side? And also, how did ZS help you overcome that?
In general, I would say that the tech industry has very low representation of women in general. Tech industry or data science industry in general has like very low women representation. So there have been a lot of times when I have been the only woman in the room. So that was one of the biggest challenge, I would say, at workplace. Some might say that, why do you think it's an issue, right? Because I enjoy the limelight. I get to prove myself. But it's not about that. I would say it's more challenging because you feel isolated at times, right? So, and that feeling of isolation in itself can be very demotivating, I feel. Even since college or when you are going to school, right, there are always these preconceived notions, at least in traditional orthodox families, that most people would consider that women are less technically proficient than a man, right? They're not suited for some of these high-tech roles, and they are more adept to any of the soft skill or a teacher kind of a role, or they wouldn't have preconceived notions in their mind that, okay, a non-technical job is more suited for a woman, right? And it's even more aggravated when you come back after a break, right? I would say ZS has put in a lot of emphasis or concentrated effort, right, to ensure some of these challenges are heard and resolved, right? The core values are we live by treating people right, we get things right for our clients, and we do it right, right? So with that, I think we view inclusion, equity, diversity also in an expansive way. So we welcome and celebrate all the visible, the invisible elements of multiple groups that exist. So as I mentioned, there is a Women at ZS group. There is Pride at ZS. We had the June month wherein we celebrated in the firm, and it was attended by almost like 1,000 plus employees in the firm. So there are these different subgroups that exist within DEI, and so that there is a feeling of community, there is a feeling of rich collaboration and exchange of ideas, and in general, individual growth and well-being, right? Which helps in bringing diverse perspectives, ideas, and I think in general helps in greater client impact.
Great. And also for any kind of growth, I think a mentor is very important. To have the right person to guide you and, you know, grow you in the company. So do you have any mentors in CS that you can talk about? And also throw light on how, you know, a typical mentor-mentee session would look like.
I have been very fortunate to have like good PD coaches. So there's a concept of professional development coach at CS. So as soon as you join the firm, you will be tagged to a professional development coach. Okay, and this person is different than a project mentor. And the coach or the PD coach will help you unlock your potential primarily and will enable you to self-discovery.
I think it's very, very important to have a good mentor. Yeah. Just coming to the end of a session, any advice you would like to give women, you know, considering a career in data science? Again, touching upon like how it has been always assumed to be an industry or a sector which is male dominated or something like that. So what is the advice that you would like to give women who are, you know, thinking of getting into this?
Couple of advice that have worked for me. I'm not like an expert, but whatever has worked for me and I would like people to learn from my journey would be to develop a solid technical foundation, right? So ensure that you have a very solid grasp on the core data science skills, be it programming, machine learning, data visualization. All of these are the basis or core of the work that we do typically, right? Technology is advancing, changing. So how do you expand your technical knowledge, right? Through online courses, through certification, hands-on projects. As I mentioned, there are different coding clubs. How do you join those? Learn from the community in general. So how do you seek out to your mentors, right? Find like experienced people, be it man or a woman, doesn't matter, right? So who will work with you, who will guide you, mentor in terms of navigating any challenges that you're facing, helping you identify your growth opportunity. It could be your PD coach, your project mentor, as I mentioned. Also build a diverse network, as I mentioned, that there are multiple programs wherein I'm working with external partners, internal partners. Even my clients have been great help in terms of shaping my overall journey at ZS as well. So how do you tap into that network and collaborate and be an inspiration to each other, right? And in general, women, even if they are like 100% prepared for a conversation, they would still want like more and more effort put in. While a survey says that men, if they are like only 60% prepared, they would just go in with full blown conversation and come out with flying colors. So how do you embrace that confidence and be that self-advocate, right? So don't underestimate your abilities. Speak up, share your ideas, be an advocate for yourself.
Some of the wonderful things that you shared here is definitely going to be an inspiration for a lot of people, you know, who have their apprehensions of women in certain industries and sectors.